Very good morning to all the children. Yes, Vidya, today we are going to revise writing skills. Okay, so already you have appeared for the test of writing skills and literature, but as per my observation, most of the students, they could not attempt questions based on writing skills. So basically formats were there only and you were not knowing exactly, and you lost your marks. 2 to 4 marks you lost out of 20. So I'll be teaching you all the formats again, so revision of formats only, and you can get from 4 to 8 marks in between on writing skills out of 40. Now you're preparing for revision test 2, as well as you're preparing for your periodic test to be held in the next month in the beginning. Fine. So first of all, let's do notice. Notice, speech and business letters, they're part of your term 1. Fine. I'm talking about whole term 1, not about the revision test only. So we are going to do notice. So what is the format of a notice? First of all, a box is there, you should know. And then after that, beta, in the beginning, name of organization or name of issuing authority. This word can also be there. So note down, name of organization. Which organization? Which is putting up the notice on the board. Clear? As well as if the word changes, they can flip it also for confusion. Name of issuing authority. Fine? The authority which is giving you the notice. Fine? Then after that comes the word notice. Suppose a club is there. It can be a club, it can be a school, a university, any organization. Fine? Fine. After that, beta, name of the organization. Then what should be there? The word notice. It should be written. Date on the left side. If date is written before writing the word notice, that is also acceptable. But these 4 things should be there. Fine. So name of the organization, the word notice, date, and heading of the heading or title. One and same thing. I'm not going to discuss the content now. I'm going to just tell you the format. Fine. So heading or title comes after that. Now, it should not be one word title. It should be up to 3-4 words, which will tell us that what is the content of the notice. It can be a notice based on you lost some object, an object was found, any announcement of any inter-school competition, any announcement of any program workshop to be done in your school. You can get a question that notice is written. Within the notice, there are blanks and each option is doing A, B, C, D. Pick up the right option. Fine. So in that way, you should know everything. You should be prepared. They can ask you, okay, what comes in the here at the firstly, what is to be written over here in the notice at the topmost line? Fine. Whether it is name of the organization or whether it is heading of the title, the word notice itself or date. Those who have gone through the format only, they will be able to answer that. At the topmost thing is the name of issuing authority or name of organization or name of institution and city also sometimes. If city is to be mentioned, it should be mentioned in the same line. Fine. After putting comma over there at organization and city. Clear? You cannot say ki ma'am ne nahi karwaya. Chote bachche nahi ho. You have to be smart enough to perceive. After that, beta, what is the content? What, where, when? How? So all the factual details are given in the content of the notice, that what is to be you can say an inter-school competition is going to be organized, is going to be held where? In the school auditorium. When? On 15 September 2021. Fine. How? Now the eligibility, the target group. You should know everything. Target group means for whom that notice meant. You can get a question on that also. Anything is possible. Now, target group is suppose any announcement is there fine. Announcement regarding losing something or finding something in the class or in the school. The target group for whom this notice is displayed is class only, section only, the whole school, all the monitors. In that way, confusion can be created. So you should know ki what is the statement. Firstly, read carefully and accordingly give the answer. Fine. There were many questions pouring in by you people that, ma'am, what sort of questions in writing skills you have seen? One idea you got, fine, after appearing in the revision one. So then at last, beta, signature in running hand, name of the person and designation if it is given. This is the format of our notice. You have been doing notice since class 5th only. Signature, name and designation. You can ask where the designation is given. Fine. Do you write any salutation? Salutations are there in the letters only. Fine, there is no salutation in notice. Anything in that way. So is it clear to all of you? Send me your feedback, children, 15 students, those who are attending class at home. Is it clear, beta? Vaibhav and Vansh, they have still not joined. Very good. They think that they have won everything and they are not supposed to join anything. Never attend the class. And again, I tell you, yesterday also I gave reminder that you people are taking very casually your online class. You think that we need not join online class. Fine. So your attendance is marked absent. Chahe aap ek period mein present hote ho. Now, and you will see the consequences soon. So speech is there. Second, there is no heading in speech. Ye bhi question tha aapka. Kal tha na revision test 1 mein. That what is the part of the speech? Speech ended with gratitude. There is heading of the speech. Some children, they chose that there is always a heading in the speech. No, there is no heading in the speech. I'm just going to discuss the format of the speech. You can start speech with a quote of some famous personality. If not, then you can write a quotation also. This is not mandatory to always write a quote or quotation. Clear? If it is a quote by some famous personality, you put it in inverted commas. If it is just your quotation, that hard work never goes unrewarded. A very good morning to all of you. That is not a quote by some famous personality. Then you need not put it in the inverted commas. You just write the quotation, skip one line and start writing your speech. Okay. So after that, greet the audience. Greet means wish a very good morning to all, to one and all present here. Then after that, introduce yourself. Introduction aati aapki, that I, Soumya of class plus one, stand here to express my opinion or voice my opinion on, fir announce karte ho topic. Announcement of the topic aata hai uske baad. This should be in the first paragraph only. Clear? Announcement of the topic, that I'm going to put forth my viewpoint on the topic, child labor, fine, poverty line, any topic, whatever is given to you. After that, there can be content given to you. A paragraph is written. Choose its appropriate. You can say what can be the topic of introduction. There is no title in the speech, but they can ask you that in which context this speech is about. Then second paragraph. In second paragraph, obviously, development of the topic will be there. Whatever topic is given to you, you will develop your viewpoint on it. Use of first person means you will be using the word I only. That I want to convey that. I would like to express my opinion. I would like to voice my say. In that way, you will be using first person pronoun, I, in speech. Clear? Then use of rhetoric device. What is rhetoric device? In which you ask a question to the audience and you yourself give the answer. Do you know, my friends, that how many people are living below poverty line? Let me tell you that more than 65% people are still living below poverty line. So this is just a way to capture the attention of the audience only. Clear? Topic develop karte karte, you will be using first person only. You will be using rhetoric device once or twice, not more than that. Fine? Then you can add news excerpts, headlines, facts, data to make audience believe what you say. आपने बोला मोर देन 70% पीपल आर लिविंग बिलो पॉवर्टी लाइन, दैट इज अ डाटा इन इटसेल्फ और अ फैक्ट आल्सो. देन न्यूज एक्सर्प्ट, रिसेंटली देयर वाज अ न्यूज इन द ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द न्यूज़पेपर्स रिगार्डिंग द फार्मर्स. फाइन, सो यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सम न्यूज एक्सर्प्ट्स, ऑथेंटिसिटी ऑफ योर व्हाट यू आर सेइंग. सो यू आर गिविंग प्रूफ ऑफ व्हाट यू सेड, दैट रिसेंटली दिस वाज इन द न्यूज दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द फार्मर्स आर स्टिल सिटिंग, दे आर डाइंग इन they are tired and they are not getting proper amenities and facilities, whatever your topic is all about. Clear? So after that, in third paragraph, you need to conclude your viewpoint. So my dear friend, conclusion kaise hota hai speech ka? Conclusion can be a warning, it can be a suggestion, any positive note, a pledge. Fine, let's take pledge to end this evil of the society. Fine, it can be a warning that, my dear friends, if we keep on wasting water, days are not far away when we will be buying water only, water will not be available at our homes. So it's a kind of warning. Clear? Suggestion. Anything can be there at the end of the point, but very important thing is thank you at the end of the speech. Or paying gratitude, one and same thing. Kal jo aapko dala tha, usme being grateful to the audience, same thing. Confess or offer, or you can say pay gratitude means thank you, and generally say thank you. A speech should end like this only. This is the format. I'm not going to discuss the topics I told you, because your questions are mainly focusing on the formats and your deeper knowledge. Is that clear again, children? Send me your feedback. Dono ko clear aapko? Fine. Yes. Is it clear to all? Gursimran is there. Yes, Anjali. Very good. Dia. Everybody is sitting and attending. That is good for you only. But the last days hai, or be serious now. I want every one of you to pass with flying colors, with good marks. It's a better chance. You people are so lucky that you're going to prepare for MCQs. Fine? But you have to be very, very smart. Offline exams, you know that. True evaluation honi hai baapki. Okay? Online, I'm not saying the children who got positions in online, they are not good enough. Yes, we had online invigilation also last time on you people. But even then, the true evaluation offline, mein aap kitni der ke baad appear hone wale ho na, almost a year. And it will be a different experience. At the same time, when you will be having four options, it confuses you a lot. There will be questions in 40, I guess there will be 10-15 questions easily you will attempt without a single thought. Okay, fine. Then there will be questions, then you had to think more, little bit more efforts you will be putting in. Okay, two options will be confusing, and then you will apply some formula. Okay, nahi ye nahi ho sakta, yehi hai in context to the chapter. Fine. And then finally, there will be some questions, 10 to 15 again, they will be very difficult ones for you. उससे ही आपकी पोजीशन सेट होनी है. एंड इफ यू आर वेरी वेरी सीरियस लर्नर ऑन डेली बेसिस ओनली देन यू कैन ग्रैब, एंड एनीबॉडी ऑफ यू कैन ग्रैब द पोजीशन. डोंट रन आफ्टर द पोजीशन, रन आफ्टर द परफॉर्मेंस. पोजीशन विल रन आफ्टर यू ऑटोमेटिकली. क्लियर? सो क्वेश्चंस ध्यान से पढ़ने हैं, ऑप्शंस ध्यान से एनालाइज करनी. कई बार क्या होता है, फर्स्ट ऑप्शन पढ़ते हैं, यही आंसर है, चलो जी बेटा हाउ मेनी एमसीक्यूज अदिति यू आर आस्किंग 40 मार्क्स का आपका इस बार पेपर है. फाइन दिस टर्म पीरियोडिक टू स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम सेप्टेम्बर ऑनवर्ड्स एंड दैट इज क्लियर टू यू द मैसेज. जो आपका 23rd वाला प्रैक्टिकल था दैट इज शिफ्टेड टू प्री पॉन्ड टू 9th. तो जिन जिन का मेरे ख्याल से ऑलमोस्ट सबका कोई ना कोई प्रैक्टिकल था उस दिन 23rd और 21st थर्ड. सो मेक श्योर जो 23rd वाला आपका प्रैक्टिकल प्री पॉन हुआ है आई हैव पुट मैसेज इन पेरेंट्स ग्रुप एज वेल. मेक श्योर यू नो दैट. क्लियर. अपनी इन्फॉर्मेशन अप टू डेट रखनी है कि 9th को आपका पेपर है. इट मीन्स यू आर गोइंग टू पेयर. फर्स्ट एग्जाम आपका 9th को ही हो गया. फिर अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस लेट मी टेल यू आर गोइंग टू प्रिपेयर फॉर योर ASL ऑल्सो. दैट इज असेसमेंट ऑफ लिसनिंग एंड स्पीकिंग. फॉर दैट वी आर थिंकिंग ऑफ कंडक्टिंग ऑफलाइन और ऑनलाइन. दैट वी विल टेल यू दैट स्पीकिंग स्किल्स विल बी कंडक्टेड. वी विल बी आस्किंग यू ऑब्वियसली समथिंग. अ टॉपिक विल बी गिवन. यू आर सपोज टू स्पीक ऑन दैट टॉपिक एंड देन यू विल बी अवॉर्डिंग. वी विल बी अवॉर्डिंग यू मार्क्स. एंड एज फॉर द लिसनिंग टास्क we will show you a video or we will send a video. If it will be online then we will send you one video. You will watch that video but rather than watching you will listen to it carefully. theek hai dhyan se sunna hai. And on the basis of that we will share one Google form link with you. And on the basis of that you will be attempting MCQs or subjective also. It can be subjective or it can be objective. That we will tell you. So you have to attempt that. aapka listening speaking 10 marks each way. Clear? So in English you can get, and in all subjects you can get full marks, which it's up to you only that how to prepare well. Fine. Do attend your classes also. So let's continue with the yes beta. After this let me discuss business letter ka format karna, all the business letters. सबसे पहले किसका एड्रेस आता है? सेंडर का कि रिसीवर का? एनीबडी रिमेंबर्स? यस प्रभ आपको याद है बेटा. सेंडर का आता है पहले बिकॉज फर्स्टली वी विल सेंड द लेटर देन इट विल बी रिसीव्ड. ऐसे याद रखने को बोला था मैंने आपको. क्लियर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नाउ लेटर राइटिंग बिजनेस लेटर फॉर्मेट ऑफ लेटर राइटिंग बेसिक फॉर्मेट जो सबका सेम है. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सेंडर्स एड्रेस. फाइन आपका ये पेपर है जैसे. ठीक है सेंडर एड्रेस होता है. आफ्टर एंड सेंडर एड्रेस कैन बी 2-line एड्रेस और 3-line एड्रेस. नो कॉमास नो फुल स्टॉप्स इन दैट. फाइन देन वी हैव डेट. स्किप 1-line एंड डेट. Again, skip 1-line. Receiver's address. In the receiver address, one recipient should be there. The manager, the director. Fine. The owner, whatsoever designation is given to you. अगर नहीं है, आपको invent करना पड़ता है. Recipient should be there. Then address line होती है. Second में और third में city होती है उसकी. Then again, skip 1-line. Subject. After this comes subject. After subject comes salutation. You should know these terminologies. Salutation इसको बोलते हैं. Where you write dear sir or dear ma'am. This is called salutation. Fine. Where the salutation comes after the subject, before the subject, after the subscription. What is subscription in the letter? You know that? नहीं पता ना क्योंकि ध्यान ही नहीं दिया हमने कभी. Then you start writing content. After the content, when you write yours truly, आपका name and designation, that is called subscription. Ending part. Clear? Yours truly, truly, yours faithfully, yours, fine, obediently. Then आपका name. Last में if designation is given. डेजिग्नेशन के स्पेलिंग डिजाइन लिख के ATION. यस बेटर नाउ यू कैन सी. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड सब्सक्रिप्शन. दिस इज कॉल्ड सैल्यूटेशन. दिस इज कॉल्ड बॉडी ऑफ द लेटर, जहां पे कॉन्टेंट लिखते हो. दिस इज द बॉडी ऑफ द लेटर, दिस इज द सब्जेक्ट, दिस इज सेंडर एड्रेस, डेट एंड रिसीवर एड्रेस. डेट वर्ड नहीं लिखते हैं, डायरेक्टली डेट लिखते हैं. लाइक यू विल बी राइटिंग 27 August. वॉट इज द करेक्ट फॉर्मेट ऑफ द डेट यू शुड नो. दिस इज फाइन. विच वन इज द करेक्ट? यस बोलो दिया.
27 August 2021,
फर्स्ट ऑप्शन. यस, फर्स्ट ऑप्शन. So you should know these are the very basic details, but we people are prone to commit stupid mistakes only, but we never, you know, concentrate on easy things. We start cramming the difficult parts only always. So do pay attention to each and every detail. Clear? So this is it. In the business letters, firstly, what do? You introduce yourself and then you tell the reason of writing the letter. Fine. And if it's an inquiry, then you start making inquiries. You ask about the price and the time limit and the discount offered and all. And then you expect the reply in the end and letter ends. If it's a reply by you, then you again introduce yourself and you tell that you are replying to the inquiry made by you on this date. This is with reference to reference number. And then you give reply to all the inquiries you have to assume. Fine. And in the letter of placing order, again, you tell yourself who you are, why are you writing this letter? Then you place an order, you draw that box in which you tell serial number, item, brand, quantity. Then finally, you expect the discount and the tentative duration when you expect to receive that order. You have placed an order, then at the end, you say that I expect that my order will be given to me within fortnight. Fine. And then you end the letter. And then finally, which is left? Inquiry, reply, then placing order. One more is left, letter of complaint, in which you complain, but in a very formal way you complain. Dear sir, I am this. I am writing this letter with reference number this. Fine. Then you start complaining that you recently purchased something or you recently attended something. People did not attend you. You recently visited a mall. People did not attend you. So you start complaining in a very formal way. At the end, you expect that jo bhi aapki kharaab cheez nikli thi, replacement can be there or they can mend it. Or if next time you visit the place, their services will be good enough. So complaint is always, it can be about the services you received. It can be any object you received, anything. Clear? Don't be fixed into one thing only. So is it clear to all of you? Fine. The format and the content. Yes, children, सबको ये सारी राइटिंग स्किल हमने आज डिस्कस की है. Now, how you will be preparing for English? Because you never know next week में आपने कितने कम बच्चे आते हैं already. How you will be preparing for literature specifically? Rather than mugging up the questions from the guides, what you're supposed to do? You're supposed to read the chapter with understanding. Fine, read it once, twice, thrice. Thrice one chapter, if you read with understanding, there are some hidden meanings in the chapter. There are some literal meaning in the chapter. Apni vocabulary strong karo. Fine. Kuch apna find out karo how to solve some comprehensions you can solve out online. MyCBSEguide.com. Fine. They provide n number of topics to in all the subjects. CBSE has authenticated site. Fine. So prepare well. And read all the chapters and then appear in the exam. Okay, bell has gone. Bell ho chuki. Okay, I'm going to end this lecture. Okay, have a nice day. And do attend registration ke liye 1 to 14 hours jo aa rahe hain proper school uniform mein kal bhi.